Hey everybody, it's Bishop Barron. I'm in the Word on Fire studio today, and today is September the 8th, 2020, which means it's the fifth anniversary of my ordination as a bishop. And I must say, this morning when I was doing my holy hour in my chapel, I kind of let my mind just sort of drift over the past 5 years, and I was just so grateful to God for all the amazing things that have happened, have taken place these 5 years. I was thinking about right after I was ordained, the World Meeting of Families in Philadelphia took place, and I spoke at that. And that's right when Pope Francis came to this country, and I was doing some commentary for NBC News at the time. I think, too, of that marvelous Eucharistic Congress in Cebu in the Philippines. That was, I think, in January or February of 2016. I think of, remember the Jubilee year for priests that we had, and I had the opportunity to go to Rome and speak to the English-speaking priests who had gathered there. I think it was that same summer, that was 2016, we had World Youth Day in Krakow. I think that's still the biggest crowd I've ever spoken to in this giant arena, and it was just so moving to see the young people in the hometown of Karol Wojtyła. I also spoke at World Youth Day in Panama 3 years later. Also, 2018, World Meeting of Families in Dublin. Again, a beautiful gathering there. And then I had the privilege in 2018 to attend the Youth Synod in Rome. I was elected as a delegate and had that really thrilling experience to spend a whole month with the bishops who were there and with the Pope every day. Had the joy, too, of being chair of the committee, the USCCB Committee on Evangelization and Catechesis these past 3 years. I think of some of the Word on Fire things we've been able to do in these last 5 years. We launched the Word on Fire show, with Brandon. We did our first one, I think it was the day I arrived, or right after I got here in L.A. We founded the Word on Fire Institute, which is going great guns in Dallas. Completed the filming of Pivotal Players. I started that when I was still in Chicago. I think we did six of them, and we did the remaining six during the summers I've been out here. What a joy that was. Also, the Mass and Sacraments DVDs and study programs, those were all filmed while I was out here. We, of course, overhauled and renewed all of our production and video offerings at Word on Fire. Had the chance, too, the last several years to speak at the U.S. Congress. That was a thrill just about a year ago. At YouTube headquarters, Facebook, Google, Amazon up in Seattle. Oxford University, I gave a talk last year for Newman's canonization, the Angelicum in Rome, many more. My mind was going back to some of the books I've been able to write since I've been out here, including Letter to a Suffering Church that, by God's grace, went out to a lot of people around the country. And then finally, I was thinking of all the things I've been able to do in this wonderful Santa Barbara pastoral region. I knew almost nothing about it when I arrived 5 years ago, but I've really come to love it, not just as a beautiful place, but as a place with beautiful people. And boy, have they been through some challenges these years. Think of that terrible Thomas fire that at the time was the largest fire in the history of California. The ensuing mudslide in Montecito, just about 10 minutes from my house, that killed about 25 people. We had a mass shooting a couple years ago took place in my region. So the people have faced, some real challenges, but boy, have they risen to the occasion. Grateful for all the opportunities to drive around this beautiful big region of mine, to visit the 40-some parishes, to go to the schools and the hospitals, the nursing homes, the prisons. For many years I was a professor at Mundelein, and I was rector, and this has really given me a chance to exercise my pastoral muscles a bit, So that's been just a tremendous joy. And so on this fifth anniversary, I'm just filled with gratitude. If you had talked to me, 5.5 years ago, I would never have imagined I would be here in Santa Barbara, California. Never would have seen the previous 5 years coming. So it's the grace of God. When I first came out here, I kept going back to that passage from the scripture about Abraham, where the Lord says, get up, leave your home country and go to a land that I'll show you. And that's been my model these past 5 years, is going to this land that I knew nothing about, and the Lord has shown me some wonderful things. So grateful to all of you who follow Word on Fire, grateful to everyone who's benefited from the work we've been able to do, and grateful finally to God for these last 5 years. And God bless you all.